Hello and welcome to Let's Read the Books of Daggerfall. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. Today I'll be reading Brief History of the Empire, Part 1, which I found in the Citadel of Hawkfield on a random drop on a spell sword in Alcair. A Brief History of the Empire, Part 1. Before the day of Tiber Septim, all Tamriel was chaos. The poet Tresizis called that era the days and nights of blood and venom. The kings were a petty lot of grasping tyrants who fought Tiber's attempts to bring order to the land. But they were as disorganized as they were dissolute, and the strong hand of Septim brought peace forcibly to Tamriel. The year was Second Era, 896. The following year, the Emperor declared the beginning of a new era, so we began the Third Era, Year Aught. For 38 years, the Emperor Tiber reigned, a just, pious, and glorious age, when justice was known to one and all, from serf to king. It reigned for a fortnight after, as if the land of Tamriel itself was weeping. The Emperor's eldest living son, Pelagius, came to the throne. Though his reign was short, he was as strong and resolute as his father had been, and we could have enjoyed a continuation of the Golden Age. Alas, an unknown enemy of the Septims hired the cursed organization of cutthroats, the Dark Brotherhood, to kill the Emperor Pelagius I as he knelt at prayer at the Temple of the One in the Imperial City. Pelagius I's reign lasted less than 3 years. Pelagius had no living children, so the crown of the empire passed to his first cousin, the daughter of Tiber's brother, Agnareth. So did Kintira, former queen of Sylvanar, assume the throne. Kintira I was blessed with a time of prosperity and good harvests, and was an avid patroness of art, music, and dance. Kintira's son was crowned, after her death, the first emperor of Tamriel, to use the imperial name Uriel. The Emperor Uriel I was the great lawmaker of the Septim Dynasty and a promoter of independent organizations and guilds. Under his kind hand, the Fighters Guild and the Mages Guild increased in prominence throughout Tamriel. His son Uriel II reigned for 18 years, from the death Uriel I in Third Era 64 to Third Era 82. Tragically, the rule of Uriel II was cursed with blights, plagues, and insurrections. His tender-heartedness inherited from his father did not serve Tamriel well, and little justice was done. Pelagius II inherited not only the throne from his father, but the debt from the poor financial and judicial management. Pelagius dismissed all of the old elder council, and allowed only those willing to pay great sums to return. He encouraged similar acts of his vassals, the kings of Tamriel, and by the end of his 17-year reign, Tamriel had returned to prosperity. His critics, however, have suggested that any advisor of wisdom, but without gold, has been forcibly ousted. This may have led to some of the trouble his son Antiochus faced when he became emperor. Antiochus was certainly one of the most flamboyant of the usually austere Septim family. He had many mistresses and nearly as many wives, and was renowned for his grandness of dress and good humor. Unfortunately, his reign was rife with civil wars, surpassing even that of his grandfather, Uriel II. The War of the Isle in Third Era 110, 12 years after Antiochus assumed the throne, nearly took the province of Somerset Isle away from Tamriel. The united alliance of the kings of Somerset and Antiochus only managed to defeat King Orgnum of the island kingdom of Paeandenea due to a freak storm. Legend credits the Sigic Order of the Isle of Arteum with the magic behind the storm. The story of Kintira II, heiress of her father's throne, is certainly one of the saddest tales in modern history. Her first cousin Uriel, son of Queen Potenna of Solitude, accused Kintira of becoming a bastard, alluding to the famous decadence of the imperial city during her father's reign. When this accusation failed to stop her coronation, Uriel bought the support of several disgruntled kings of Hyrok, Skyrim, and Morrowind, and, with Queen Patena's assistance, coordinated three attacks on the Septim Empire. The first attack occurred in the Iliac Bay that separates Hyrok and Hammerfell. Kintira's entourage was destroyed, and the Empress was taken captive. For 2 years, Kintira II languished in an imperial prison believed to be somewhere in Glenpoint or Glenmoral Weird before she was slain in her cell. The second attack was on a series of imperial garrisons along the coastal Morrowind Islands. The Empress's consort, Kontin Erinx, died defending the forts. The third attack was a siege of the imperial city itself, occurring after the Elder Council had divided the army to attack western Hyrok and eastern Morrowind. The much weakened government had little defense against Uriel's attack and surrendered after only a fortnight of resistance. Uriel took the throne that night and proclaimed himself Uriel III, Emperor of Tamriel. The year was Third Era, 121. Thus begins the War of the Red Diamond, described in Volume 2 of this series. Thank you for listening to Let's Read the Books of Daggerfall, Brief History of the Empire, Part 1.